Okay students, so next question is question number 3C. What it says, fx equal to x square minus 25 by x plus 5. X not equal to minus 5, they have said strictly. Means x you don't have to take minus 5, okay. So x what value you will take? All the real numbers except minus 5. Okay, what is the question? You have to check whether this function is continuous or not. As a whole I have to check now again. So in how you will check? I told you, right, graph of this, whether it breaks or not, that I have to check. Now you don't have to check at x equal to minus 5. At x minus 5 you don't have to check. Why? Because x not equal to minus 5, they have said. So in what value I will check? All the values except minus 5. Okay, so in first question, remember we have checked for x equal to only 3. So at 3 only we used to check. They have said strictly in the question that check fx is continuous at x equal to 3 or not. So at x equal to 3, when they say, we used to check only at x equal to 3 whether it will break or not, like this, right? But in this case they have said check the continuity of this function. Here they have said x not equal to minus 5, means here you don't have to check x, you don't have to take minus 5. Other than that, everything you have to take x now. Okay, so only at minus 5 I will not check. If it breaks also, I will not check this one. Other than this, whatever points are there, everywhere I will check whether the graph will break or not. Okay, so how I will check? Very simple. See, if I don't have to take here minus 5, first I will say that if I take minus 5, then what will happen? You can see if I take x minus 5, this will become minus 5 square 25 by 5 minus 5 plus 5. What it will become? 0 by 0, indeterminate form. Okay, indeterminate form means we don't have. If I take x minus 5, y value we don't have. Don't have means what? That point will not be there. So obviously the graph will break here at this point. But remember, you don't have to check at this point. So even if the graph breaks at minus 5, I don't have to see that. Okay, because they have said check the continuity of this function at every point of x except x equal to minus 5. Okay, so rest of the point I will check whether it is continuous or not. So if I take x 0, I will check at x equal to 0 whether the graph will break or not. At x equal to minus 1, the graph will break or not. At x equal to 1, graph will break or not. At all the points I will check. So obviously one by one I cannot check, right? So in general I will check. So how I'll check that one? So through graph it's very easy to find out. How? You can see, if I take x anything other than minus 5, if I take 1, then also y value will get something, right? So x, if I take 1 suppose, then also I will get here 4, here minus 24. So minus 24 by 4 also will give you minus something. So somewhere here you will get the point. Okay, next, just next to 1 you take, say 1 point something. If you take 1 point something, you will get for sure point, you will get somewhere here because it will be defined. Y you will get some value. Next value if you take, you will get some point. So for all value of x, you will see y value you will get. Means what? All the points will be there. So obviously it will form a continuous line like this. So through graph you can understand. I will show you the graph of this also. Okay. Now without graph I want to solve. So what I will do? I will use the concept of limit again, right? So see how I will solve. To find out whether this function is continuous or not, what I have to show? Limit x tends to c fx is equal to fc. Okay, general point I have to take, right? C will be implied for all the points here. Okay, so as your x tends to c, limit fx is equal to f of c, I have to show. And this is what? Left hand limit and right hand limit both must be same. Okay, if you are confirmed that left hand limit, right hand limit, you will get both same, then you can directly write this one. And in this case obviously left hand limit, right hand limit will be same because it will be a defined value. Okay, so what I will write here? Given, first let me write down the given function, fx equal to x square minus 25. I'm following the same step as we have done in question number 1, 2 and 3ab. X not equal to minus 5. Okay, so at this point I have to check limit x tends to, let c be any real number. All the real number I will consider by C. C be any real number except minus 5. So for all the points I cannot check one by one, right? So I have taken in general C. Okay, all this point will be represented by C. C can be anything, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, anything it will be, okay, general point. So what I have to show, if it is general point, suppose 1, then what I have to show? Limit x tends to 1 minus, from left, if you approach towards 1, I have to show that fx will approach something. And that something, if I approach towards 1 from the right, that fx must approach towards that same thing from the right also, okay. And at that same point, at 1, I have to find out this point, if you get this point or not. If you get this point also, and you can see this points you already got, this point you already got, so it will join, so it will form a continuous line, right? So in this case I will not write C minus. Why? Because see, if I put C minus, suppose I take C minus, function will be what? X square minus 25 by x plus 5. So in this case, how you will solve? See here, limit concept when we used to bring, when it is indeterminate form. Now see, C minus, if I take, even if I take C minus, minus 5 I will never take, because they have already said that you have to take x all the value except minus 5. So minus 5 I'm not going to take. See what you will take, whether if you will take either 1 or 0 or minus 1, 1 or 0 or anything you will take from the real value except minus 5, right? So if you take 1 also, if you come closer towards 1, now when you write in limit, first what we will check, whether it is determinant or indeterminate value. Now if you don't have to take minus 5, then obviously it will be always determinant value. You will never get indeterminate. Minus 5 is the only value here which will make this one indeterminate form. Okay, so I don't have to look for C minus or anything here. Directly I will, what I will do here, directly I will put C. Okay, because it will be determinant value for sure. Okay, so that's why I'm not writing C minus. I hope it's clear, because if you write C minus or C plus, in the same function you will directly put C here, because it will give you determinant value. Okay, so whether it is C minus, I will put C here. If it is C plus also, I will put C here. Okay, if you are not understanding this, means you have not seen limit properly. So the video which I've made on limit, please see that video first. Okay, so what I will write here, x square minus 25 x plus 5. Okay, this I will write C directly. Okay, I'm finding this one first, then I will find fc and we'll see that whether both are same or not. So in this case, now see, two ways are there. Either you will simplify this one first or directly you put C, doesn't matter. Okay, so this one I will simplify first. Limit x tends to C x plus 5, this is what, x square minus 5 square, that is a square minus b square form, x minus 5 by x plus 5. So this gone. Limit x tends to C x minus 5, which is equal to limit, no need to write C, directly put it C minus 5. Okay, so what I got, limit x tends to C, I got C minus 5. So let's find out fc now. Okay, if fc also give you same thing, then your problem solved. Then fc will be what, C square minus 25 by C plus 5, which is equal to C square minus C minus 5 into C plus 5 by C plus 5, gone, C minus 5. So what I got, limit, remember this is for all value of C except minus 5. If it is minus 5 also, if you have to take, then remember you will get indeterminate form. Then you cannot simply write x tends to C, because we know that if your C will be minus 5, this will be minus 5, this will be indeterminate. For that, remember what you have to do, simplification or identity, those things you have to use it. Okay, even though I have used your simplification, right now without simplification also you can do this. Directly also you can put C, after that also you can simplify, doesn't matter, because if you put here in place of x C, then also you will get determinant value, because C, I know that it is not minus 5. Okay, other than minus 5, whatever you will take, obviously it will give determinant value. So if it is determinant value, we have already studied this. We can directly put the value in place of x and solve it. Whatever comes out, that is your answer. That is normal maths only. Okay. So limit x tends to c fx is equal to fc. We got it. This one is the definition of continuous function. Therefore, f is continuous at the domain of why I'm writing domain of f. If you don't want to write domain of f, this x values are what? Domain of f, right? Remember, I've told you many times this one. X value, this is y value. So how we used to get this one? By taking those values only first, right? X we used to take from here, this will be your domain. So this is your domain. So this x values are nothing but domain of f. So this what you will take? All the real number except minus 5. So f is continuous at the domain, at all the values. Means at all the values of x, means at the domain of f. Okay? Or if you want, you can write like this. Therefore, f is continuous all real number except minus 5. Okay, except minus 5. You can mention like that also. I hope it's clear, this question. Now, next question is little complicated. Complicated in the sense it is modulus function. And modulus function, remember, we have to redefine. Why? Because modulus function, you know, if it is modulus of x, what kind of value it will give you? Always positive value, right? Now if your x is positive, that is x positive, how we used to write? X greater than 0. If x greater than 0, what you will get? Answer x only. If x is 1, answer will be 1. If x is 2, answer will be 2. Means whatever x you will take, same x will come out here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever you will take, same value will come out. But if it is negative, x is less than 2, less than 0. Okay, less than 0 means if you take minus 1, x equal to minus 1, what you will get? Then you will get 1. Can you see? This is not same. When you take x minus 1, x minus 1, your answer is not x exactly. I hope it's clear. So what we can write? If your, this is condition for x greater than 0, this one. For x less than 0, if x is less than 0, this value less than 0, then also it will be positive. So how I will write down? X equal to make this one positive, now what I will do? Minus x I have to write. I hope it's clear. Means what? If your x is minus 1, what will be modulus of minus 1? It will be 1, right? So how I will write? X is equal to minus of x. If I write, you can understand here. Minus 1, x is minus 1, right? In place of x, I will simply put minus 1. See whether it will be equal or not. In place of x, minus 1. So what you will get? Plus 1 or not? To make plus, we have to make this one as minus x. Okay? Now, this thing simply by listening, you will not understand properly. Okay? Just listen first and try to analyze yourself also what I'm saying. You have to analyze these things yourself. Okay? So these are the things which we know about modulus function. There was greatest integer function also. Remember, greatest integer function, what kind of output it used to give? Always integer. Okay, which integer? Greatest integer. Like for example, if it is 1.9, what will be the output here? Remember, I show you in the graph. This is 1, suppose. This is 2, 3, 0. This will be minus 1 like this. Now 1.9 output will be greatest integer function on your left always, right? So 1.9 will be here somewhere, right? Now which one will be the greatest integer in your left? The greatest integer is 1. You can see 1 is the greatest integer of all on your left. So this is the output here. So these functions you need to know. So modulus function already I have explained. It always give you positive value. So when I write in terms of x, student don't understand. So try to see. If I put value, everyone can answer. But when I write x equal to like this, modulus of x, if I break it into two functions, the fx equal to like this given, suppose. Then when I write, it will give you x. If x greater than 0, it will give you minus x. If x less than 0. okay, greater than equal to. If it is equal to 0 also, then also it will give you x only. Now when I write in this form, some student don't understand. The reason is you are not analyzing whatever I'm saying here. You are simply trying to memorize this thing. That is the problem. So don't try to memorize this one. Try to understand from the number. If I take inside modulus minus 1, the answer is 1. So means what? This is your x. If you take this as x, you can see output is not x. X was what? Minus 1, right? Output is what? Opposite sign of x. Can you understand? So when I take x minus 1, what is your output? Output is minus x. Okay? That's why this minus 1 means what? Less than 0. When your x is less than 0, output will be minus 1. So this will make the output positive because of this sign. Even if you take x negative, this minus will make it positive. So outcome will be always positive in this function. So we always have to break in this form. That is the better way to solve modulus function. So question number D is also same. You can see fx equal to modulus of x minus 5. So basically what I have to check here is whether the graph will break or not. So obviously the graph will not break here. That we know. Okay, but still we have to write in terms of limit, so you need to understand all these things properly. Okay, and yeah, the graph of this previous question, question number C, you can see this one. The function is fx equal to x square minus 25 by x plus 5. Now see here, the graph looks continuous at every point. Okay, at every point it seems like the graph is continuous, right? But it will break at point, let me zoom it, at minus 5, you will see that in the graph it seems like you have the point, right? But remember, it will break. If I zoom it, keep on zooming it, what will happen? It will break here. Since this is just a point, you know that just before 5 also, if I take whatever small value you have, okay, just before minus 5, if I take that small value, very close, the close to minus 5, if I take that value, then also y will be there. Okay, so in this minus 5, it seems like the points are there, right? But in this graph also, you won't be able to figure out, because just next to it also point is there, very close to it. So it seems like it is joined. But if we ask you whether the graph will be continuous at every point or not, that then remember, in minus 5 it will surely break. Why? Because if I take minus 5 here, you won't get y here, you won't get the point here. I hope you can understand right now. Other than that, whatever x I will take, always you will get y. These are all points, remember student, I have told you in class 11 also, line is nothing but collection of all points. If you take x 4, y you will get something. Okay, x4 if I take, y will be this one. Okay, same way, if you take all the x here, y will be this point. So with the collection of this point, you can see it will form a continuous line like this. That's why it is called continuous function at all point, except it will be minus 5. But since in your question they have not asked you to check at minus 5, you can see in question number C, they have already said that you have to check whether the function is continuous or not at all point except x equal to minus 5, right? See, it is written here x not equal to minus 5. So if they don't mention this one, then it won't be continuous at every point. Remember, it will be discontinuous at minus 5. At minus 5 it will break this graph. I hope it's clear. So you try question number D. I will explain it tomorrow. Okay, you just see how you solve this one. I have just given you the hint. Try to break the function into simple forms. The function is given like this, right? Fx equal to mod of x minus 5, like this. So this function, you first break it, you have to check the graph of this one. Now how you will check? Obviously, when the graph is simple form, like equation x plus 5, then you can always draw the points right in the graph. So try to break this one also into simple form. So how you will write this? X minus 5 always will give you positive value, right? So how you will write down this one? So see carefully. Fx equal to x minus 5. If I take value here 5, what value it will give? Positive 0 it will give, right? greater than 5, if you take anything, it will always give you positive. Means greater than 5 or equal to 5, if you take x, your function will be what? Same, whatever it is there. Whatever you will take here, greater than, suppose 5 you will take, suppose 5 minus 5 will be how much? 0. You will get positive value. 5 greater than 5 if you take 6. 6 minus 5 is how much? 1. 7 minus, so same thing, whatever you will put here x, whatever after solving this one you will get, same output will be there. This will not put any effect here. Okay, same whatever exactly value you will get here, exactly same output will be there. This have no meaning at that time. Okay, so fx, what I will write? X minus 5. I hope you have understood. X minus 5, whatever answer it will give, same answer this modulus function also will give, if you take x greater than equal to 5. Okay, if you want to verify, you can verify yourself also. X greater than equal to 5 means what? X, if I take 5, 5 minus 5, how much? 0, right? So modulus of 0 is what? 0 only. Now that will given by this function also. X, if I take equal to 5 here, 5 minus 5, 0. Here also output same. So instead of writing this one modulus function, I can write this way. So I have converted into simple function. Same thing I am doing, the one I have explained, modulus x. Same thing here also. Next, what I can take? If I take x greater than equal to 5, then this will be this one, right? But if I take less than 5, if I take here, less than 5 means 4 if I take. X, what you are taking? 4. What will be your output? Here it will be 1. Why? 4 minus 5 will be how much? Modulus minus 1. So when you have this modulus function, this minus 1 will become positive 1. So see here, x, this is your x, right? X minus 5, here what it is given? Minus 1. But because of this modulus function, you are not getting same thing here. So you cannot write here x minus 5 here. What you will write here? X minus 5 you will get inside, right? This one. Now when you will take outside this one, it will be opposite sign. So how you will balance that one? Put minus here. Is it clear or not? If it is not clear, you ask me again, okay? So what I mean to say here is, why I have put minus here? So see here again, I will tell you, if you take x less than 5, suppose 4, x what I am taking equal to 4 now. So when I take x equal to 4, what you will get inside this modulus? You will get minus 1. Can you see? X minus 5, if I take 4 here, what you will get? Minus 1. But what is the output? What is fx? This is your fx, right? As a whole, fx. When I take x equal to 4, I got is equal. It is equal to minus 1. But what is the whole output? As a whole, what is the output? 1. Can you see this and this inside portion is not same? Means what? What I can say? This and this output is not same. Means fx equal to, I cannot write directly this one, fx is equal to what? It's not equal to x minus 5. What it is? Opposite sign of this one. You can see this one, what I got? Minus 1. What is the output? Plus 1. Means what? Opposite sign, right? So how you will make opposite sign this one? By putting another minus here, right? If I put another minus here, this will become positive plus. This answer you will get. That's why I put minus here. I hope it's clear. That's why your class 11 basic is very important here. Okay, so even if you have not understood this, try to understand this one first properly. If you have doubt on this one, then ask me, I will explain this again. Okay, and this is very simple concept actually. So if you have understood properly this one, then this you will easily understand. So you have to check fx is continuous at x greater than equal to 5 or not, then you check x less than 5 or not. At this points the function will be continuous or not, you check. Means graph of this one you check. Okay, so you try to solve this one with the help of limit. Tomorrow I will discuss this one with you. Okay.